Good morning, boys and girls. Color is everywhere, including in chemistry. I am in a world of colors. I am in a chemistry lab. I have got potassium permanganate, which is purple in color. I have potassium chromate, which is yellow in color. I have copper sulfate solution, which is blue in color. I have the original copper sulfate salt, so which is blue in color. A chemical gets its color by electrons absorbing energy and becoming excited. The excitation absorbs wavelength of light. What we see is the complementary color of the absorbed wavelengths. Chemicals are identified by the colors. Some chemicals are identified by their odor, that is a smell. Some are identified by their pH value. Some are identified by their boiling point, that is using a thermometer. Some chemicals are identified by their reaction with the other substances. Solution is a common term used in our daily life. Components of a solution, types of the solution, expressing the concentration of the solution, all these are a part of chemistry. Whenever you are a student or a chemist or a scientist, you need to conduct experiments, and for that you need a laboratory. At present, I am in a chemistry lab. You need to conduct experiments here. We have to record the observation, and we have to arrive at conclusions. So that is the basic terms of a scientific method. The apparatus needed for this experiment are, first one is a burette. This is called a burette. The capacity of the burette is 50 ml. It is starting from 0 ml and then it is ending with 50 ml. So this is the first instrument, that is burette. So we have to wash the burette. For washing the burette, keep it close to the tap. This is the way to wash the burette. And drain the water into the sink. And we can clamp the burette onto the burette stand. This is called a burette stand. So we are clamping the burette. This is a washed burette. The second instrument is, the second apparatus is pipette. The capacity of this pipette is 20 ml. And how to wash the pipette? For washing the pipette, collect little bit of water in the conical flask. And pipette water and wash the pipette well. This is the way to wash the pipette. Drain it into the sink. So that also can be kept safely. Keep the pipette in such a way that it will not be rolling down. The third apparatus needed is a standard flask. And the capacity of the standard flask is 100 ml. And this should be washed. Collect water and wash the standard flask. We need a small funnel, and that funnel also should be washed.